Hey, church family, welcome back to Pause to Pray. This week it is June the 7th already, if you can believe it. Time is just flying. June is quickly passing us by, and in the theme of everything that we are going through in the month of June, we're going to be praying alongside our students who are graduating this year. We always celebrate in our church students celebrating graduating grade 6, grade 8, and grade 12, as well as we are always praying for students who are in college or university. So today we're going to be praying for our students. I know Pastor Brian was leading us last week in prayer for them, and we're going to continue doing that today. A couple other things, though, that we're going to be praying for today. Our sports camp is coming up quickly as well. July the 11th, it begins. Going to be a very exciting week. I am so stoked to have Scripture Union coming back this year for a full 5-day camp. They are hopefully sending us back one of our awesome coaches that we had last year, and getting to know her. She's now one of the head coaches. Be great to have her back. We're also really excited because this is our biggest sports camp ever. And if you are interested in making food to help with some of the snacks for sports camp, or if you are interested in showing up and helping, we would love to have you join us in this awesome outreach ministry. So we're going to be praying for these kids today, but we are also going to be praying for volunteers and praying for the people who will be doing ministry in many different ways. Coaches, volunteers, staff from the church who are all playing their parts in this awesome outreach ministry. The last thing I want to be praying for today is in line with what we're going to be talking about on Sunday, which is, you'll find out when we read the passage on Sunday from Luke chapter 10, how similar it is to Matthew chapter 10, which we preached about and learned about last week. And last week was the sending of the 12. This week is the sending of the 72. You're going to realize, wow, these passages are so similar, but there's something different we're going to highlight this week. And it's the reality of this spiritual battle that takes place every day for people who live on mission for Jesus. So we are going to be praying about the spiritual battle that goes on around us every day. It's something that we honestly don't do enough of. I am sorry for not praying more along these lines, but we're going to be praying today. We're going to be praying that God equips us with the spiritual armor we need, that we trust Him, that He gives us victory in the spiritual realms in ways that just our efforts alone are never going to be able to accomplish. It is also raining on me right now, so I'm going to get praying because I don't know how much it's going to rain on me. But let's pray together about these things and whatever else God puts on your heart. We're not going to rush it. Let's start off just with a moment of silence. Quiet your heart before God together with me. Father, we lift up our hearts to You. We open up our hearts to You today. God, I pray that we would learn to trust You more and more as we follow You on mission every day. And God, we need You. We begin this time praying together by acknowledging our need for You. You are the one who forgives. You are the one who restores. You are the one who gives life. You are the one who saves. You are the one who gives us purpose and meaning. It all comes from You, God, and we acknowledge that together. Father, as we come before You in prayer right now, we want to lift up some of these fantastic ministry opportunities that You have blessed us with, and we don't want to squander them. We want to take them seriously. We want to be ready to share the hope of Jesus with whatever opportunity You give us. So we lift up, first of all, sports camp today. I pray that as a church, we would rally around these young people, 75, 80 kids from our town, who get to hear about You, who get to witness the lives of people serving You, people on mission for You, and this powerful testimony that it is to them. So God, I pray for these kids. I pray that You would bring the ones who don't know You to a saving knowledge of You. I pray for the ones who do know You, that You would strengthen their faith, that You would give them godly examples, people to grow with, whether they're coaches or volunteers, people who inspire them. Father, for the coaches, for the volunteers who are helping with sports camp this year, I pray that you would gift them with everything they need to be the coaches, the volunteers that they need to be, who are not just there to help run a camp, but are there to help share the hope and love of Jesus. And when we get a chance, God, if there's any coaches this year, or any volunteers, I should say, who maybe don't know you, but are coming with a friend who they want to help with, God, I pray that there would be a powerful ministry opportunity there too, for some volunteers to get to encounter you and know the love of Christ. Father, we pray for young people in our church too who are graduating. We lift them up again. We pray for your hand to be on them as they make decisions about the future, whether it's which high school to go to, which college to go to, what job to apply for. God, you are the one who gives them wisdom. You're the one who guides them. I pray that if there's any in our church who maybe aren't following you, but they obviously know about you, that this would be a time in their life where they respond to that call that your Spirit has put on their lives to follow you wholeheartedly. And that doesn't necessarily mean that we're praying for them to be pastors or full-time ministry people. If you're calling them to that, that's great. But God, we pray a blessing on the people who are going to become doctors and construction workers and people who are going to become assistants to, oh, I don't know what, any job that we can't imagine, but I pray that they would do them well, do them in a way that is service to you, not to people. And yeah, we pray a blessing on all these young people in our church graduating, going through these milestones of life. And lastly today, God, I pray for an awareness in our church family of the spiritual forces of evil that seek to derail us, that seek to distract the people we are ministering to. So Father, I pray that you would give us as a church spiritual armor and protection to go about the ministry that you are calling us to do. I pray that you would give us boldness, that you would give us direction. I pray that your Spirit would protect and guide us. And in all of this, God, we want to honor you. So first, we honor you. We focus on you. We don't focus on the enemy. We don't focus on his schemes, but we focus on you. We trust you. We declare our trust in you today, God. And we pray for your protection on us and on the people that we are ministering to. We love you, God. And we pray this all in your powerful name. Amen. I don't know if you can tell, but I'm just starting to get kind of wet here in the rain. So normally I'm not walking up the stairs on my way back to the church when I'm recording these videos, but hey, you know what? I'm going to go dry off. Whatever you are doing today, I pray that God blesses you as you seek to serve him. I pray that he guides you, directs you. Thank you for being part of the church family here, because it is a blessing to follow Jesus with you. So wherever God takes you today, go with him. Go in peace. We'll see you next time.